Federal Attorney General Mark Dreyfus has been accused of a possible breach of the ministerial code of conduct surrounding investments made in his self-managed super fund. Dreyfus is the latest Labor minister to come under fire for their investments, the opposition calling on the Prime Minister to take action.
In politics, if you want a friend, get a dog.
I'm out of here. Toto needs a little friend.
Because question time is rarely a friendly affair.
At least three ministers have now disclosed that they own shares when the ownership of shares is specifically barred under the ministerial code.
The opposition accusing Anthony Albanese of failing to enforce his own ministerial code of conduct. Zeroing in on the Attorney General, Mark Dreyfus.
The Attorney General invests in funds which have significant holdings in businesses which he is responsible for regulating.
I will examine the matter.
The shareholding owned by the Attorney General has effectively doubled in value since the Labor Party came to power.
That has been raised.
It doesn't pass the pub test. It doesn't pass any test whatsoever.
In July, the new PM said this.
I want politics to be cleaned up, and that's why we will have strict adherence to the code of conduct.
However, since that time, a number of ministers have failed to comply with the code, yet they've retained their jobs despite the breaches.
How is it, Mr Speaker, that this Prime Minister is pretending to uphold some different code or some different standard when there is no, absolutely no consequence?
And I tell you what, if you want to talk about integrity, you're going to have a big chance. Your big chance is next week when there's a National Anti-Corruption Commission bill presented to this parliament.
Today's coalition attacks perhaps a case of the pot calling the kettle black.
While the opposition took aim at integrity today, most of the parliamentary week was focused on the economy, with the release of current accounts data as well as rising interest rates. It's sure to be the same next week, with the unemployment figures due on Thursday. Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.